This video will show you how to use user-defined functions in Thermo-Calc, which is how you add variables to a plot that are not available by default in the software. There are many quantities you may want to evaluate as a result of a thermodynamic equilibrium calculation, which are not directly implemented in Thermo-Calc. The software enables user-defined functions to fill some of these gaps. For example, you can work with derivatives, such as the thermodynamic stability function, or do simpler functions, which we show in this video, how to plot the total mole fraction of solid phases. I will calculate the fraction of solid phase as a function of temperature for an iron chromium carbon alloy. This calculation can be run by anyone with a license for Thermo-Calc, including the free educational package. The calculation is based on graphical mode example T7 of the examples included in your software. If you want to run the example file as it is, go to the Help menu, Example Files, Thermo-Calc, and double-click on example T7. To begin, select the one-axis equilibrium template from the home screen of Thermo-Calc. All the nodes we need to run the calculation will appear in the project pane. We will begin by working in the System Definer. From the Database drop-down menu, select the FE Demo database. Then select the elements Iron, Chromium, and Carbon. We'll set Chromium to 12 and Carbon to 2, which automatically sets Iron to 86 mass percent. Now select the Equilibrium Calculator node. Under Axis Definitions, set the temperature range from 1500 to 1700 Kelvin, then set the temperature to 1500 Kelvin. The temperature you set here at the top of the program must be somewhere within the range you set below. Now click the Functions tab at the top of the panel. This is where you add user-defined functions, and I'll show you two separate ways to do this. The first is set in terms of quantities. You can set as many quantities as you like, and they are labeled Q1, Q2, and so forth. In this example, we'll only set one quantity. Set Q1 to amount of phase, which is what we're looking for, and set the phase to liquid. Next, we'll define the function. Name the function fraction solid and define it as 1 minus Q1. Since we are looking for the fraction of the solid phase, we subtract liquid, which we defined as Q1, from the total, which is 1, because the system size is 1 mole. If your system settings have been changed so that the system size is no longer 1 mole, use the number you have in your system settings. Our first user-defined function is now set. The second way to set a user-defined function is to use Thermo-Calc console mode syntax. You can read about this syntax in our online help system. From within Thermo-Calc, go to Help, Online Help. The system will open in your browser, but it does not require an internet connection. From within the system, search for variables and units, and then select thermodynamic variables and units. This section explains the console mode syntax and offers some examples. To continue with our example, click the plus sign under Function Definitions to add a second function. Name the function f_solid and set it to 1 minus np parentheses liquid unparen. np means mole numbers, so this is 1 minus the mole of the liquid phase. The second function is now set. These examples represent two ways to write the same user-defined function. Now that we have entered our user-defined functions, we can plot them, select the Plot Renderer node. Under the Y-axis, change the variable to Function. When we click on the drop-down menu, we can see that the two functions we just entered are both listed. Select the top option, Fraction Solid. Uncheck Automatic Scaling so that we get a good range. Then click Perform at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, a plot will appear in the Visualizations window. This shows the fraction of the solid phase as a function of temperature, just as we set. Next, we'll plot the other function. Right-click on the Equilibrium Calculator node, hover over Create New Successor, and select Plot Renderer. This time, we'll set the function to the second option, F_solid. Uncheck the Automatic Scaling box, then click Perform at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, a second plot will appear in the Visualizations window. This plot is identical to the first, but we can see that the Y-axis is labeled according to the name we gave the function. If you liked this example, don't forget to press the like button and feel free to leave a comment with the type of video you'd like to see next. We are constantly working to create new examples, so make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any new videos. And check back regularly for new videos on our website at thermocalc.com.